Spectronaut is structured in different levels. The highest level is called Perspectives, and you can find them at the top of the window. Within each perspective, you can often find several pages separated into tabs. The layout of each page is normally structured into a left menu, tree containing elements, nodes, and the right panel containing information related to the selected nodes. This information is represented as plots, reports, and summaries. Let's have a quick overview of the available perspectives. In the library perspective, you can generate and review spectral libraries. Moving to the analysis perspective, you can set up the analysis either using a previously generated spectral library or by utilizing DirectDia, a proprietary biognosis workflow for analyzing DIA data without the prior step of library generation. Once the analysis is finished, you can visualize your data with in-depth information on run, protein, and precursor levels. The post-analysis perspective will give you an overview of the results on the experimental level, but also allows you to explore results of differential abundance analysis. If you would like to export detailed information on the qualitative and quantitative results of your analysis, you should use Report Perspective, with one of the predefined report schemas or your own customized one. In the QC perspective, you can visualize multiple metrics related to quality control. The pipeline perspective allows you to set up a job monitoring workflow, which is very helpful for big dataset analysis, or a pipeline workflow, which is very useful for setting up subsequent analysis of the smaller datasets. The database perspective contains all resources needed for data analysis, like FASTA files or modification database. In the settings perspective, you will be able to generate your own settings schemas for all the workflows available in the software. Finally, in the About perspective, you can find information on the software version you are currently using, your personal activation key, and last but not least, a software manual with a detailed description of software functionalities and features.